Good morning. I was born to love you. Queen. That's one of Gary Sharon's favorite bands. Two favorite bands, he told me. Queen and The Who. Gary C. See, Gary? Oh, headlines of insanity. Trump's fight with Congress gets first day in court. So this morning I had a delightful little encounter. We have a high of 44 degrees here today on May the... That's not the delightful little story. The awful low temperature and geoengineered weather here on the eastern seaboard in the spring. There was an article in the propaganda rag known as the Boston Globe yesterday. The corporate governmental propaganda of this Orwellian, Huxleyan nightmare society system. An article about the weather here, about we're not getting a spring. We hear this so many times now here in New England. No, we don't get a spring. It's just rain and cold and overcast. Well, it's because it's geoengineered, because they're controlling people's minds about the climate collapse and its effects. And how and what it actually means, which is near-term extinction. They've been doing the geoengineering weather modification for 70 years. Go to geoengineeringwatch.org, which is now being censored by in the search by Google. Doesn't even appear. Was number one. Today is the moon of May. The month is the moon, and yesterday was Monday, or the moon's day, of the mama moon, mother of all matter, and today is the 14th. Yesterday was the 13th of Mama May, of the blossom blown blessing of the bull, Taurus. Today is the 14th, and the moon, you can see, is waxing on, getting fuller and fuller, and will be full on the 18th, coming Saturn's day. Tuesday, Wednesday. Tuesday is Mars Day, Norse for Mars. Wednesday, Woden's Day, Norse version of Mercury, Hermes in Greek, Thoth in Egyptian. 16th, Thursday, Thor's Day. Thor is the Norse version of North version of Jupiter, or Zeus, or Jesus, Jesus, God's risen Savior. Sol Amon, the sun and the moon, the lights of Lucifer, Diana Lucifera, the bearer of loose light. Of Lux in Latin, L-U-X, light. 17th, Friday, Frau's Day, Freya. Norse for Venus, or Ishtar in Babylonian, or Hathor, or Isis in Egyptian. The goddess of the free dome of Friday. Saturn's Day, Saturday, the only one that has its Latin name, Saturn's Day, Saturn. And then Sun, the Sun's Day, God's Sun. Who is really all seven, secretly, mystically speaking. And I have 5 cash register synchronicities. So this morning I met Robert Kennedy at Whole Foods, I shit you not, who turned out to be a guy who I'm very simpatico with intellectually. I'd seen him in there before, in the eating breakfast. Today, as I was walking by after using the bathroom and getting ready to leave, he was there with his New York Times, and I'm pretty grouchy in the morning, so, you know, based on what his appearance in the past, I get a real nasty streak to me, especially, like, in the morning before the coffee, and or as I'm drinking the coffee. And, so he looked to me just like this, I don't know, I mean, who knows what my bias based on his appearance, but the New York Times thing. I walked by and I said to him, it just happens where I had no idea that it was going to end up being some guy who I'm he even knew what James Corbett is. His name's Robert Kennedy, and he was sympathetic with my take on Chomsky, you know, the being an academic geek here. It was just amazing. Like I said, I came right out and said to him, never having met him, him knowing nothing about me, me knowing nothing about him. And I just came right out, and what did I say? How's the propaganda this morning? New York Times propaganda. And we ended up talking for like, I don't know, 5-10 minutes there as I'm just standing there and getting ready to go. And my goodness. Oh, look, top stories. Coca-Cola Air arrested with $1.3 million in cannabis. 5,000 plants. A Greek billionaire and heir to the Coca-Cola fortune was arrested on the Caribbean island of St. Kitts after a search of his private jet uncovered more than $1.3 million worth of cannabis on board, according to local news reports. Cannabis. Still criminalized around the world. Yep. Mary Jane. So anyway, Robert Kennedy, I told him about my synchronicity with... This man is probably like in his 70s. He's just such a nice... And he said to me when I told him, you know, after I had said a few things to him, he said, this is an interesting convergence. I mean, that really made my day. So, Robert Kennedy, thank you. Gosh. Yeah, I mean, I wasn't expecting that. I was expecting him to defend the New York Times. All right, I don't know what maybe I wasn't expecting anything. Maybe unconsciously I knew he was going to be sympathetic, friendly. Just really interesting. So this morning I'm going to read to you chapter 2 of Carl Jung's The Undiscovered Self. Or actually, let's do Synchronicity, his Synchronicity essay, since I'm going to share with you these cash register synchronicities. And I wrote down yesterday all of these videos that I want to post along with this one on my WordPress page are the associations. I don't expect you to be able to make any sense out of that. There's not going to be no quiz. Carl Jung Synchronicity Essay, 1952, PDF. 1952 was the year that he published the essay. He worked with a physicist. There's actually changing views of synchronicity from Carl Jung to Robert Perry. Let's see if this is... this is a little article on it, so I don't know if this is going to help. Nah, that's not really good. How about this one here? Synchronicity and PSI, how are they related? PSI is referring to psychic phenomena. Whoa, is that small print? John Palmer, University Hospital, Zurich. Abstract. Let's just read a little bit of this. Whoa. Let's read the abstract. Let's just read that. Oh my goodness. Carl Jung's interest in parapsychology was kindled by personal psychic experiences, especially an anomalous banging sound emanating from a bookcase while he was in the company of Sigmund Freud. He also had an interest in spiritualism and communicated extensively with J.B. Rhine about experimental parapsychology. I read J.B. Rhine's The Reach of the Mind, which was in my mother's bookcase, when I was in my late teens, in addition to reading The Undiscovered Self, little paperback version. Not only did I read them, I comprehended them at a very early age. I wouldn't say like thorough, complete comprehension, but you know, beginning to at that point. Because here's the thing, it takes a long time sometimes for the integration process, for it all to settle in, especially if you get programmed through education with noise. Sometimes you have to clear away the clutter, you have to empty your cup in order to fill it with new information and, or an altogether new paradigm framework. He also had an interest in spiritualism and communicated extensively with J.B. Rhine and experimental parapsychology. He credits parapsychology with influencing the development of his theory of synchronicity. The purpose of this paper is to compare and contrast synchronicity experiences with PSI experiences, or psychic spiritual experiences. Jung defined synchronicity as the occurrence of a meaningful coincidence in time, quote unquote, the occurrence of a meaningful coincidence in time. Regarding time, Jung generally viewed the elements of a synchronicity as simultaneous, but he did allow for a temporal relationship akin to precognition. With respect to meaning, Jung insisted that to be synchronicities, coincidences must reflect the activation of archetypes, primal themes of good and evil inherited from our ancestors, and be of psychodynamic relevance to the experiencer. The coolest thing about the meeting I had with Robert Kennedy this morning at the breakfast table with his New York Times was how at the end he recognized me as a non-dualist. It was cool to be affirmed in that sense. I mean, I'm not part of this whole I Am A society where I form views based on identifications. But that's exactly what non-dualism is referring to. It's that you don't have this rigid self-identification with physical sensory qualities, inherited qualities like gender and age, or, you know, things that are totally sensory, which limit perspective. Like the lady who said to me, well, I'm a woman. And she was defending President Johnson after I had told her the quote where Johnson says, "He who controls the weather will control the world." President Johnson said this. And she didn't even hear that and said, "Oh, I like Johnson. He was good." And then she went on and said she didn't like the Kennedys because they're womanizers. I'm a woman. I said, I wasn't talking about this. She goes, "Well, I'm a woman." As if they were womanizers. Yeah, but that's not, it's not that they weren't rapists, okay? And I'm sorry, but so was Johnson, a womanizer, okay? Look into his history, for crying out loud. Non-dualism. But I wouldn't call myself that, because if once you start getting into this self-identifying, whether you're saying, you know, I am a non-dualist, I am a pacifist, then you're in opposition. So when you say the irony of this, like Krishnamurti points out, calling yourself non-dual, non-violent, that puts you in opposition to the violence. And what is the cause of violence, as Krishnamurti says? The primal, original cause is me. Me in generally, as in ego, as in I. Because when you say that, you take that position, you're identified, then you're in opposition to everyone and everything else. And you will be in a fight. It's you against the world. Instead of you and the world. You in the world, you of the world, and not of the world at the same time. In the world, not of it. Regarding time, Jung generally viewed the elements of a synchronicity as simultaneous, but he did allow for a temporal relationship akin to precognition. With respect to meaning, Jung insisted that to be synchronicities, coincidences must reflect the activation of archetypes, which are defined as primal themes of good and evil inherited from our ancestors, and they must be of psychodynamic relevance to the experiencer. PSI experiences are not so restricted.
Braude, B-R-A-U-D-E, has criticized Jung for erroneously claiming that events can have inherent meaning. This problem can be overcome by saying that events differ in their capacity to evoke meaning in a person. Which events have this capacity must be defined by consensus among Jungian scholars. Jung postulated that one element of a synchronicity must be an experience and the other an objective event. This would seem to exclude pure telepathic experiences as examples of synchronicity. Synchronicity is unpredictable in the same sense that ESP card-guessing subjects cannot reliably predict whether any given response would be a hit. Jung performed an astrology experiment, finding that married couples shared astrological signs relevant to marriage more frequently than chance. But said that such statistical significance was not necessary. Parapsychologists would not be so generous. Synchronicity cannot be the consequence of volition, which would seem to preclude most laboratory PSI results. However, one can solve the problem by postulating that violation only accompanies PSI in experiments. Mansfield, who sees no overlap between PSI and synchronicity, subsumes PSI under Jung's principle of, quote, general acausal orderliness, unquote. At the level of physical theory, Jung subsumed synchronicity under quantum mechanics as interpreted by Pauli, Wolfgang Pauli, that's the physicist that Jung worked with, and also saw correspondences to relativity theory. Compared to theories of PSI, synchronicity theory comes close to Stanford's conformance behavior model, but Stanford insists conformance is causal. The controversy over whether it makes sense to consider synchronicity acausal can be viewed as a semantic issue related to different definitions of causality being implicitly adopted by Jung and his critics. So long as synchronicity can be considered by to some degree nomothetic, it can be tested empirically. At the physical level, testing can be considered isomorphic to tests of related PSI theories, such as the observational theories. Assuming a list of archetypes and evoking circumstances can be gleaned from Jung's writings. The theory can be tested psychologically by comparing test results under synchronicity, conducive and non-conducive conditions. Jung suggested that evoking trance-like states in a sense of the miraculous can evoke archetypes. One might also explore manipulation of the archetypal content of ESP targets. Introduction. Because parapsychologists populate a borderland area of science, we have always been grateful when eminent scientists and scholars in other fields reveal a positive interest in the subject. Even more so if they make constructive intellectual contributions to it. One such eminent scholar active during the early to mid-20th century was the Swiss psychiatrist Carl Jung. As noted in an excellent review by Roderick Main in 1997, Jung's interest in parapsychology was kindled by personal psychic experiences. Perhaps the most famous of these involved Jung's mentor, Sigmund Freud, who at the time was skeptical of psychic phenomena. During an argument about parapsychology, a loud sound, like an explosion, emanated from Freud's bookcase, Jung, 1963. When Jung denied that this anomalous event was paranormal, Jung predicted that it would immediately reoccur, and right on cue, it did. However, when the same thing happened to Freud again, when Jung was not present, Freud discounted the original experience as being, Freud discounted the original experience as being paranormal. McGuinn, 1994. It was not until many years later that he expressed acceptance of psychic phenomena. Freud came to accept it. Or was this Jung? I don't know. What the heck? Yeah, Freud. Freud came to accept it years later. His continuing difference with Jung on this matter has been cited as one of the reasons for their breakup. Jung also was very interested in spiritualist mediumship and attended a number of seances, including one with the famous Rudi Schneider, during which anomalous physical effects were observed. Although he found mediumship fascinating from a psychological point of view, by virtue of the dissociated states in which the medium entered, he did not, at the time, consider the attendant phenomena to necessarily be paranormal. Later, however, he experienced anomalous phenomena in a guest house in Britain where he had spent several nights alone, and as he subsequently learned, was reported to be haunted. One class of phenomena, dripping water, he was able to account for normally. Jung credits his experiences with psychic phenomena as helping him develop his psychological theory, especially the concept of synchronicity.
The mind and the body. Psyche, Libra, even, eve of evening, and Soma, of the dawn of Adam, of Odd, of God. God of the body, the devil or double, single God, double of the mind, or the psyche of evening. Sunrise, sunset, Horus and Set on the horizon, of the equator of equilibra, Om, of justice and judgment, of the judgment day, D, of the doorway, of the four, of the quartors, quarters of the year, of the Taurus. Taurus in your cerebellum, the back of the brain, the motor cortex, and the throat of all stories told, of all buildings, buildings, of all stories built, bold, of the Masons of May, of Beltane, of the Bull, of the Baal, of Kabbalah, the Lord, of El, of the 12. And then Gemini in the arms and the lungs, Cancer, the crab of Christ, Krishna, in the breastbone of the sternum, the hard shell of the crab, here in the chest of the crest of the wave of Christ, the best. 12 o'clock, the summer summit of the year, the peak experience. And then the descent down to D-Aun, D-1, done to 6 through the equinox of the fall, or Autum, of the tomb of time, of the 12. So Adam is the body created first, Eve is the mind, the psyche created second, Eve of the V of the 5, of the valley. There were actually 6 because I wrote this one down. 14 items at 6:14 p.m. This one had 14 items as well. At 3:38, the total was 3808 at 3:38 p.m. of the HH88. Of ABC123. Of the cunning linguists. Of the tongue. A linguist is a tonguist. Of Atan. Atan, the sun. In ancient Egypt, the disc. Of Yang. Yang is the bull. Of Angus. Yin is the Libra. Isis, right hemisphere of the brain. Tree of the 3. Of the goddess. Of the serpent going to Eve, the mind, to convince Adam, the body. 6525, 15 items. 652515 items. Five alive. Roman numeral V, 5. Eve equals 32 in English gematria. 3 plus 2, 5. Of the freezing of the ice. Is. Us. 23. 1, 2, and 3. Or 32. Eve. 1, 2, 3 above, 2 below. The spirit ether of the five quintessence on top. A-E-T-H-E-R. Of the pent alpha, the five A's of the bull, Aleph, the letter A, the Phoenician Aleph. How do you know all this? A lot of independent personal research and analysis. Development. Unfolding. 31 times, 631, 13 items, 3113, 44 of the mask. And look at the invoice number ending in 77, 877. Christ equals 77 in English gematria. Of all wishes granted. 4772 total. 7777 on either side of the decimal point. (clears throat) 17 items at 743. 43, 4 plus 3, 7, 7, 1, 7 items. Look at the invoice number, 908, 17, 9 plus 8, 17, E plus L, 5 plus 12. L is God in Canaanite Phoenician, singular, as in the phonetic of the letter L, which is from the Lamed and the Lambda. Lamed in Phoenician, Lambda in Greek. L, all, parallel, par-all-L. 12. God is all. God is number. All is number. Numerous, numinous, spiritual. 43, 13 total. 7, 4, 11. Criminal justice system that we have. Just ice, pole ice, who tell you to freeze and enforce the criminal justice. Force you to obey unjust laws. 13 items on the 13th, invoice number 617. And then look at the total. 2791. Excuse me, this is 917, not 617. 917, and look at the total, 2791. 791. Invoice number, 791. 917. 17. 10 plus 7. L, again, the pair of L. Paral Elijah. Elisha. Hallelujah. Hare Krishna.